into the first race in Lourdes was, I felt great. I had a really good off season of training and felt really good from first run of practice. And then qualifying, I dropped in and just had a pretty big crash. Not ideal, but at the same time, I knew the speed I had and I knew I wouldn't make that mistake again. So I just needed to focus and try to have my best run. Yeah, it went smooth, no crashes, no big mistakes. That was awesome, man. Getting that win was really special.
Man, yesterday was rough. I knew I kind of had a good run in me, and I was just happy to put down a solid one, and man, I'm pumped.
Yeah, that's sick. He threw down the gnarliest run. I could just see him do that, for sure. Bit disappointed to come eighth and was really hoping to get on the podium, if not win it, so it's going to make me, you know, train really hard and want it more, so we'll go to Fort William, start the season off from there.
So we are in Nové Město before our first World Cup this year. It's my home race, one of my big goals every year. I started very good this season. We won Cape Epic together with Susie and European champs in marathon. I felt very strong. And it's something special for me because I know a lot of spectators and a lot of fans.
Amazing race. I mean, my best race after the Olympic race in London. So I'm really satisfied because I had a lot of problems last year and 2 years ago. And I'm back, and it's amazing for me and for team.
Yeah, Fort William was wild race for me. It was a wild race for everybody, actually. It was just crazy weather all weekend. The wind and the rain was just, like, brutal.
Everything was kind of looking good, but I think, again, I just put too much pressure on myself from winning it last year and wanting to go back-to-back, and I just made silly mistakes in my race run, and that kind of added up, and that track is so hard to race anyway, so for me to get down and get six, I was still pretty happy with it, but knew that I could definitely do more.
That weekend was definitely a victory, like, for me. I was able to pull it together and put down a solid race run. Yeah, I was still able to get second and almost get the win. So for me, that was a great weekend as well. Leo Gang was, I don't know, man. I probably never stopped hearing about that race. Everybody still that talks to me and just wants to talk about the chainless run. So it was cool for me, man. Coming across the finish line there, it was, I definitely really wasn't expecting to win, but I didn't know. I thought maybe a top 10, maybe a top 5. So when I crossed the finish line and saw that I'd won it, it was pretty unreal. One of those moments I guess I'll never forget. Yeah, hard to explain. Those are kind of, as a racer, the moments that we are always searching for.
Managed fourth, not too far off the win. Still a good race for me, and I feel like that's where I turned the stone and started to have fun again and start to kind of ride looser and start riding more on the edge and more like I did last year. Yeah, Lenzerheide was a new track again, and it was almost easy to go fast because it was a lot like Australian track back home. So I was feeling really good and, you know, had some good practice runs, but still wasn't enough for the win and ended up fourth there again. So I guess that's the one that made me kind of realize that I need to start riding on the edge. From there on out, I felt like I stepped my game up.
It was a tough track. There wasn't a whole ton of lines and it was really slippery. You know, it's really hard to find the edge of how fast you could ride without making mistakes. Unfortunately, the race run just didn't go how I wanted. I almost had a big crash in the first rock garden. I almost went over the bars. Definitely a frustrating kind of run for me, but at the end of the day, it was like, well, we had tons of challenges and was able to still get some points and keep the jersey. And it was still a good weekend for me and one of those good kind of learning weekends.
Lenzerheide was good for the cross country team as well. Jaroslav managed to finish the race in first place again.
And the course was incredibly hard because there was no place for the rest. I went my own tempo, so I'm satisfied about my performance because I'm on the top. It's second victory this year. It's amazing.
Also the women's race, Lea got there just after the marathon world championships. She was very motivated and actually managed to finish in second place, her best World Cup result ever.
Started from behind and then just kept picking off girls and feeling better and better, and then last lap, attack Yolanda, attack Catherine to get second. Yeah, I'm just so excited. I'm so pumped up.
Yeah, St. Anne, it's probably one of my favorite races of the year for sure. Been racing there. I mean, it was my first World Cup back in 2008, and I've always done pretty well there, and I really like the track and the town and the vibe. I was feeling good, but just didn't put down my best run. So that was another one of those really challenging weekends where it seemed like nothing was really going right. And got seventh there, so still able to put down a decent run in the conditions and maintain the lead. But it was definitely shrinking at that point.
Yeah, race run, it honestly went pretty good. I only messed up a couple little things, but you know, getting third there, as much as it wasn't a win, it still kind of felt like a win for me. It kind of just cleared my head, and I knew I was still up the top and knew that I could still win one of these things this year. And from there on out, I was gonna have fun with it and see what the result was after that.
Wyndham was awesome, man. Probably the funnest race of my whole career so far. It was amazing. I was able to finish first in qualifying and finish first in the race. So I had, you know, kind of home country, home crowd. There's nothing that compares as far as racing to kind of being able to win in front of the home crowd, and everybody was just going nuts. And that was a special day. Like I said, probably, you know, the best of my career and one I'll remember forever. You know, things were going in the right way again, and wasn't losing points anymore, which was good. So we went into Val d'Isole. That's one of my favorite tracks. But it was a tough week, and I've never had to go down to the last race of the year with everything up to you. Basically, it's yours to win and, you know, yours to lose. I definitely looked at it more into it's mine to win, not mine to lose, even though I had a little bit of a points lead. And I was just excited for the challenge. If I could take it down to the last race and make it exciting and wrap it up, for me it'd be kind of an extra personal victory to be able to handle that and make it happen. So yeah, I just went for it, had a, you know, good run, solid run, but you know, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't thinking about it almost all the way down the track. It was yeah, I still was able to get the win there, so that was pretty awesome to win up the title with a win, and it was pretty cool.
Yeah, Val d'Isole race run, I was going for it and not holding anything back, and just had a silly little crash where I just washed the front end and punched the dirt and got back on my bike and still made it down to the bottom in third place. So it was a wild run, and I felt on it that weekend and kind of just glad that I'm not too hurt.
Annika, she was actually incredible. Managed to win the race by a few seconds, and it was incredible. It was her very first World Cup win.
Back and forth with Yolanda and me the entire race. In the last lap, I felt like I had the gap, and I just put the hammer down. But man, I enjoyed it. It was one of the most emotional things ever.
I guess my season each year starts to ramp up towards the end, and there's always World Championships at the end. So after the last few World Cups, I've definitely known that I've been one of the fastest, and I don't think I could be in a better place right now. I feel like everything's falling into place, and just hopefully I can't have any more bad luck. Race run was pretty wild. I came into one of the steepest sections just off of a bridge and just hit the rut, landed on a bank, slippery bank, and then started swapping it. Next thing I know, I'm looping out somehow. So another crash, but almost podium and got six. But I think next year will be really good and come out swinging.
I feel like I'm gonna win it eventually, and when I do, it'll make it that much better, hopefully. So I'm excited, man. The season was amazing, so I'm stoked and happy for Luke, man. He's been so close all year, so it couldn't have gone to a better guy.
It was almost a perfect season. You know, Aaron won some World Cups, and I was pretty close to winning some World Cups as well, and I've still got a lot of years to try and get first overall and win more World Cups, and if I keep doing what I'm doing, I'll definitely get there soon.
The wins were all amazing. You know, how that played out was just crazy, more than I could ever imagine. So definitely, you know, the greatest year of my career for sure.